Oh boy, this sure has been a long time coming. The Legend of Zelda: The Wind Waker HD. I'd say I do a playthrough of this game like a year ago, but I was like, oh no, I'm gonna play the other Zelda games, well, most of them, before getting to Wind Waker. I only have to cover Zelda 1, Zelda 2, Zelda 3, Ocarina of Time, Link's Awakening, Majora's Mask. It won't take that long. Well, it sure took a long time because I just dragged my feet on, getting to this. Also, I played Wind Waker on the GameCube, the original version, but not the HD version, so this is relatively new to me to some extent. Not that new, but there will be some content I will not be familiar with. Some people prefer the look of the GameCube version, especially when modded onto a computer with enhanced graphical stuff, but I think the HD version has its own kind of aesthetic that's kind of neat. Just a little bit too much bloom, apparently. Yeah, you gotta let this music play. It is wonderful. This game was trashed so badly when it was first revealed back in 2001. I want to say it's 2001 when it was first revealed. Because back then, the remnants of Sega's campaign of games have to be for boys and teenagers and adult men got carried by Sony through the early 2000s. And on the turn of the century, with the PlayStation 2 being the most popular, well, Sony PlayStation in general being the most popular console for gamers, the fact Nintendo went out and made the next Zelda game look so cartoony in contrast to their previous installments, Majora's Mask and Ocarina of Time, it did not sit well with a lot of people. It felt like they were, how do you say, like they were appealing to an audience besides themselves. But it wasn't like that at all. Miyamoto really just wanted to create a game with a beautiful aesthetic for the time, I think. Either that, he was trying to appeal to the chibi audience. I guess we're gonna watch the intro right here, right now, but it's not part of my save file, so we're probably gonna have to watch it again when I start playing the game proper. In which case, I'll probably just skip ahead. Know what? No. I'm just gonna press start right away. We'll watch the intro through the game file, because that way I'll actually, I'll actually commentate on it. There is actually some advantages to playing with the Wii U gamepad, so you know what? I'm actually gonna do that right now. Gonna switch to playing with the Wii U gamepad, because it means the inventory gets to stay on the gamepad, which clears up the screen. So, an advantage for you all. And we'll call ourselves Link again, because gotta be born like that. Also, we can play Hero Mode right away. But I won't do that, unfortunately. It's been such a long time since I've played, and I don't think the game works well in Hero Mode. And it's basically, I don't want to replicate the Twilight Princess experience. Anyway, this is but one of the legends of the people speak, something like that. Long ago, there existed a kingdom where a golden power lay hidden. That's the Sacred Realm. Or the Triforce, I should say. It was a prosperous land blessed with green forests, tall mountains, and peace. So basically, Ocarina of Time, Herald. But one day, a man of great evil found a golden power and took it for himself. So basically, when Link got trapped inside the Temple of Time because of the Master Sword, because of that, Ganondorf got the Triforce. With the strength of his command, he spread darkness across the kingdom. But then, when all hope had died and the hour of doom seemed at hand, a young boy clothed in green appeared as if from nowhere. Yeah, because he got put back into the timeline by the Master Sword. This is Adult Link, specifically. Wielding the blade of evil's bane, he sealed the Dark One away and gave the land light. Because no one else did anything to stop the man. This boy, who traveled through time to save the land, was known as the Hero of Time! And the game says, oh, he left on a horse into some lands, but really, it's Zelda that sealed him away. That's what happened. Anyway, the boy's tale was passed down through generations until it became legend. But then, a day came when a fell wind began to blow across the kingdom. The great evil that all thought had been forever sealed away by the hero. Well, no, turns out, it didn't last forever. Seals never last forever. Once again crept forth from the depths of the earth, eager to resume its dark designs. I was about to say dark rain. The people believed that the hero of time would again come to save them, you know, because no one can actually take care of the land themselves or something like that. Incompetent people. But the hero did not appear because Zelda sealed them away back into the past in a different timeline, so no more heroes. Maybe I'll play Let's Play those games too. Anyway, faced by an onslaught of evil, the people could do nothing but appeal to the gods. In their last hour, as doom drew nigh, they left their future in the hand of fate. The hands of fate. Because they why would they be able to actually take care of the freaking problems themselves? No, they have to rely on chosen heroes or gods. Nothing else. Anyway, what became of that kingdom? None aim to know, but we will know while playing this game. Anyway, the memory of the kingdom vanished, but its legend survived on the wind's breath. On a certain island, it became customary to garb boys in green when they came of age. Clothed in the green of fields, they aspire to find heroic blades and cast down evil. The elders wished only for the youths to know courage like the hero of legend. More like they were hoping one just random boy would end up being a hero. Unfortunately, the game doesn't really show that really well, the whole legend about garbing every single boy in green and stuff. It's really only our character who does that. It's too bad. It would be neat if a game actually had that kind of shtick, where all the boys were clothed in green in the hopes that they would end up as a new hero. Man, I gotta clean this Wii U gamepad. It's full of dust everywhere. Also, there's partial voice acting in this game. More like sound cues or voice clips or something like that. Oi is very much a Japanese idiom for hey or hi or something like that. Although there will be English sound cues too. Come on! Also, that the girl is Aril. In case anyone's wondering. I knew you'd be here. She's actually our sister, Link's sister. Hehehe, this is my favorite spot to get is out at the sea. When I play with the gulls, I call it Ariel's Lookout. So do you remember what day it is today? You're still half asleep, aren't you? Did you forget? Big brother, it's your birthday. That's why Grandma's been waiting for you to come back to the house. She's been waiting for a while now. It's a good thing I came to find you. Should probably go home and see what Grandma wants, don't you think? Okay, ZL for targeting. Hurry up, big brother. Grandma's waiting for you back at the house. I'm sure everyone else on the island wants to say hello to you, too. Camera control! Actually, this is even back in the GameCube. This was the first game to have some kind of camera control. Back in the GameCube version, it was the C-stick, and now it's the right analog stick for the Wii U HD re-release. Will I 100% this game? I'm not sure. I never did. I've never beaten this game 100%. I always missed out on a single piece of heart, so I may, in fact, just beat the game normally. Just a forewarning. I will be doing all the content I can do, though, assuming I have the time for it. Oi, Link. Hey, is it shoot it if you have a little courage and run as fast as you can jump into that rock out there? Huh? Is it? Is it? Tell me! Yes, it's true. Can't go over there though. Wow, I hope you'll be able to jump like you someday, Link. I just saw a wild pig! Oh, see? Look, that black one there! Don't you see him? This is perfect. My wife was just telling me how she really wanted a pet. You ready to go grab it, Link? Now, you can't just run up to it. The pigs are too alert to their surroundings for you to just jog up and capture one. If you want to get close to one, you have to hold ZR to crouch and tilt left stick to crawl it slowly up behind it. Slowly. You can also distract it with bait, I guess. Yeah, you can crawl in this game. Now, if only Metroid could crawl too. No, Metroid can only slide. Yeah, there are stealth mechanics in this game, by the way. You are hidden while in grass, to some extent. They kind of drop it later on, though. The stealth mechanics aren't that big of a deal in this game. Oh, come on. This is dumb. You Z-target the thing and instead you roll. Yeah, there are some control issues. Again, also, you don't have to go behind it. You can just go right up to it if you want. Unfortunately, you can't talk to the guy while holding it. There's hardly any point to this. Don't piss off pigs, though. Let's yell him. That's correct. You're a smart one. You, my friend, have just targeted me. You see, when you press ZL, you can target certain objects. I, for one, use it quite often to talk to folks who are far away from me. Of course, even if there isn't anything around to target, you can press ZL to face forward, you know. It's quite handy indeed. There are a myriad of other ways to use targeting as well. Quite an ingenious little thing, if I do say so myself. Of course, that's not the only trick in my bag. Not remotely. I can teach you a few more things if you'll just climb up that ladder over there and drop by my room. Ladder right here. It's too bad he still keeps waving as if you haven't done anything to him before that. Actually, after ended the thing. You're growing up, Link, which means you're gonna need as much wisdom as you can get from this point forward. If you want to be wise, you must first know things. Now, I was born before you, so I know all sorts of things. Yes, I've been studying all manner of topics for many years now. Now, I can tell you're a smart lad. Lately, I've been thinking it's time for me to pass down some of my wisdom down, and I think you're the one I'm going to pass it down to. Count yourself lucky, lad! Everything that you see tacked to the walls here is something that I've researched thoroughly. And before you ask, yes, I do know my filing system is odd. Organizational issues aside, however, it's all extremely useful information. You would do well to read it all very carefully. Reading leads to knowing, you know! Such a racket! Can't you keep quiet? You knock everything off my shelves, you dared, dratted hooligan! Honestly, the hooligan I'm referring to is my younger, much less intelligent brother, who lives just downstairs. He hates studying. All day, every day, the lout just exercises and practices with his weapons. Does he exercise his brain? No! The brain's a muscle too, I think. Anyway, the only thing he does study is the art of fighting. Right now, for instance, he's been studying fencing and whatnot, as if that's of any use to anyone. He simply doesn't know how to do anything besides exercise. I ask you, what's a brother to do? Well, we're going to be doing a lot more fencing than thinking here. Anyway, yeah, these two are basically tutorial guys. However, most people know the guy downstairs a lot more than this one. Not to mention, this guy's design right there is very much peak Wind Waker. Just the forehead being bigger than the head to the point to show that, oh, this guy's big brain. Literally! It's kind of funny, but then you got peak Wind Waker design here, too. He keeps trying to put that booger back into his nose occasionally, too. Yes, very much peak Wind Waker design characters with very strange proportions. Like, you look at Link, and clearly he's supposed to be conventionally attractive by the game's design standards. But then you see that grandpa, that guy that was up there, and the booger kid here, and it's like, in some cases, they just stretched proportions in such a way that look just like they were trying to make the weirdest design they could. Yep, to carry a jar, you just have to go in front of it and press A. Pretty much everything the NPCs say in the start are basically advice on what to do to play the game. You can already swim. Unlike Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask, you cannot dive underwater, and you have a limited amount of time you can actually swim out to, you know, out into the ocean. Ironically enough, the timer is not actually long enough to keep you from going across oceans, thanks to a special glitch that was left in both the HD re-release and the original. It basically involves going back and forth and back and forth, or pressing the start button in a rock somewhere. It's weird. Just look up speedruns of Wind Waker to get an idea. Ooh, a customer! Welcome to Beetle's Shop Ship. I deal in pretty much anything and everything. Do you have anything you don't need? If you do, show it to me. I'll pay top rupees for your junk. Or do you see anything you'd like to buy? Let's buy one thing. Oh, I don't have a bait bag. Yep. I need 5 more rupees to be able to die. I wanted to buy something from him because he says, thank you! So much cheerily, but people hated this guy back then. Back when the game first released. Like, it has to be said, the game was, before it was released, it was panned almost critically before ever being released, because people did not want a game that looked like this. But when it finally came out, people recognized that the game was actually very beautiful and actually had tons of content. It was not like a baby's first game kind of thing. Of course, some people still think the game is not a real Zelda game. Like, they hate the art style, and they hate the fact that the DS games followed suit in using this Link. Well, not this Link specifically. Phantom Hourglass uses this Link again, because it's a sequel, but Spirit Tracks is not, it's a new Link. But he looks exactly the same, so it's like, whatever. I'm just trying to pick up this jar, because I want more rupees. Can you please drop 2 rupees? Damn it. I need 1 more rupee. Hello? Today is your birthday, isn't it, Link? Well, how nice for you. I suppose I should congratulate you on your birthday, shouldn't I? Well, to tell the truth, I should congratulate myself, too. We just finished our building our little hutch and paddock today. Isn't it a delightful addition to the place? Pet. Ooh, okay, so this is where we were supposed to bring the pig. So let's go get it. I guess this is why we can't talk to the guy while holding the pig. Because if we did that, it'd ruin our chance to get paid. You know, for getting the pig. Yeah, even if you move just a little bit while standing, the pig is gonna run away. There we go. Give me your money. Did I bring that little piglet all the way here just for you? Yes, I did. Well, actually, I will be spending it all in one place. Enough for a bait bag. Even more of them. Well, I think 1 is enough. And that's pretty much the entire village! There's a house over there, actually. I do wonder whose house it is. Probably this guy's house. Oi, Link. What's that? The grass is in the way. Yeah. Some kind of grass cutting tool. I think a sword is a real grass cutting tool, isn't it? So we can go under here. Yeah, you know, I'm kind of padding the gameplay right now quite a bit, aren't I? I could have just gone to the grammar right away, but nope. I gotta go all over the place. But that's the whole point, isn't it? Fun? Actually, I was supposed to play Wind Waker HD finally with my break between semesters just as soon as my third semester ended, before the fourth semester starts, but I actually went ahead and played Luigi's Mansion 3, finally, before that, because I didn't want to put it off for like another 4 months minimum, probably more in the end. So I played it real quick, and I didn't beat it 100%, but I did beat it, and that was fun. Just they made a few mistakes with the final boss, I feel. Well, one major mistake specifically, but I won't speak of it anymore. Let's get the bait bag first.
Thank you!
Make me a member's card. And when you buy lots of things from this guy, something very good will happen. You can get a silver membership if you buy 30 things. That's actually quite a few things. Normally it'd be like 5 things. If you buy 5 things, I'll give you your first reward or a bronze membership. Like, speaking of real life stuff, like Skip the Dishes, if you order like twice from that place, they make you a gold member for a month. You only have to order twice, that's it! It's not even much. Meanwhile, this guy is like, oh, you have to buy from me 30 times and then I'll give you the silver membership. And guess what? The silver membership is not worth it at all. I can't remember the reward even after all these years. Whoop. Gotta talk to our grandma. I've been waiting for you, Link.
Hi.
Link, try these on. Time certainly flies. I can't believe you're already old enough to wear these clothes. You got the hero's clothes. They look like they might be a little warm for this weather. In hero mode, the hero's clothes do not exist. They're invisible. So you just end up wearing these pajamas, quote unquote, the entire adventure. It's a cute thing, but no, we gotta look green. Don't look so disappointed, dear one. Just try them on. Today's the day to celebrate. It is the day that you become the same age as the young hero spoken of in all the legends, which is, I believe, 10 years old. You'll have to wear them for one day, so don't look so down. Be proud, child. We'll be wearing them for a lot longer. In the olden days, this was the day boys were finally considered to be men. They were taught the ways of the sword to prepare them for the battle with their enemies. We don't live in such an age any longer. Our ways are the ways of peace. That's why I only have a shield and swords on the wall right there, because it's a way of peace. We don't need these weapons. Nowadays, I suppose Orca is the only one on the island who still knows anything about swordplay, even though he doesn't wield a sword. Hanging the family shield on the wall is a decoration and honor tradition that has been carried down from those days. She just watched her grandson put on some clothes right in front of her. Makes no sense. I guess you're wearing the pajamas under the clothes. Isn't that nice, Link? They suit you perfectly. A perfect fit. Well, tonight I'm going to invite the whole town over for your birthday party, so I'd better start getting ready, shouldn't I? Your grandma is going to make your favorite soup for you tonight. I just know you're looking forward to it. The soup is actually very good. I'll go get your sister, Arrow. Weirdly enough... Okay, you know, you can still look forward. It was always a little weird, though, that pressing up on the C-stick did not do anything. Oh wow, you can still move in first person mode. What the hell? This is weird. This is not from the GameCube original. Absolutely not. You can play a Zelda game in first person. What an age. Actually, I don't think you can attack in first person, but it's still weird that you can move in first person. Absolutely bizarre. Yep. You look at the Wii U gamepad when you pause. In that sense, it's actually kind of lame that you guys can't see my inventory. I can see it on my menu, my Wii U gamepad screen right now, still, so. Like, I'm gonna equip the bag right here if I can. Maybe? Oh, it's just a bag. There's nothing inside, so. I guess, you know what? I'll buy some bait real quick. I should also clean the screen. It's full of dust. And it's still a long thing. I need to apply some lotion onto it. The one I use to clean my computer screen. Not the same thing, but close enough. But enough of talk about cleaning screens. Let's buy some bait. Unfortunately, we have to buy this. As you take control of seagulls.
Thank you. Bye.
It is not worth getting the freaking silver membership. I need to keep reiterating that. Some people just get, like, I remember people making posts on message boards about getting the silver membership and their reaction to it. You didn't need a video or even pictures to know how pissed off some people were when they finally got the silver membership. Little troll move from Nintendo. I don't remember what a gold membership does, but it's something worth. What do you want? Ugh. I hate that kid. He follows you around when you get close enough to him, and he says something completely worthless. I think I just prefer ignoring him, which is what I'm going to do from now on. Sorry, fans of that kid, but I can't stand his looks. Easily one of the ugliest characters in the entire game. There's a reason they don't show characters puking or vomiting in games for the most part, except for like Kojima, but he has no idea. He has no tact. Actually showing someone realistically vomiting on television can actually make you activate your own reflux to potentially make you vomit as well. If it's immersive enough. You look like it'd be way too hot in those clothes. I guess they're pretty neat though. So anyway, Link, can you close your eyes and hold out your hand? Just for a second. I'm gonna give you my most treasured belonging, but just for one day. Happy birthday! You got the telescope. It's your sister's most precious belonging. Treasure it dearly. At one button. Which is what we're gonna do. So, well, do you like it? You borrowed a special gift just because you're my big brother. Aren't you lucky? Hehehe. Oh, why don't you try it out right now? Just try looking over at our house from here. Let's do it. It's on the Y button. Oh, there's a guy right there. Postman looks weird, doesn't he? Looks kind of weird. Link, the sky! Look up in the sky! Yeah, you have to look up high enough to see something. It's a big bird. And then a pirate ship. That was such a long-ass reaction. Very cartoony, too. Which is weird, because that bird is actually played for drama quite often in the story. Link, this is terrible. That girl fell into the forest. She needs help. She should be dead. But of course she's not dead. She's actually alive. Also, people say this Link has emotion, but he doesn't have that much emotion. Like, he didn't even react to that girl getting stuck inside that forest. But he will have reactions to other things that he should care about, which is what's important. No, I'm not talking to you, stupid brat. What was that noise? It was awful. Better return home quickly. Yes, yes, I understand. Thankfully she doesn't do the yes-no thing. Just realize these doors have no actual handles. It's just painted onto the flat door. I've been doing some 3D modeling myself. This is literally just a rectangle. I didn't even bother giving this door depth. Ugh. Like even with the fact that I'm making some 3D models with extremely simple geometry and polygons and tries and verts and whatever, I would at least put some depth into that handle. God. Anyway, Grandma, give me my shield. Link, what's the matter? What happened? I guess it's not the shield that we need, but rather the sword. Because the girl said we better go home back real quick, but I also thought we need to go to Orca because he's the one who knows about weapons. Let's go see him. We didn't see him before seeing Grandma, so gonna have to make up for that. Oh, what is the matter, Link? You have an urgent look about you. Has something happened? Whatever it is, from the look of your face, I expect it is no laughing matter. What say you, Link? Ah, have you come for some serious instruction in the way of the sword? Yes, sir. And he just gives us a sword. Wow. Very good. Your first lesson shall be horizontal slice. Face me and press B. Do not fear for my safety. I am ready for you. Good. Keep coming at me until you hear me say very good. Very good. Next is a vertical slice. Target me and just press B. You can also do it if you keep moving forward and press the button. Despite that, during this animation you do a horizontal slice. Anyway, next thrust. Keep thrusting. Incidentally, you're supposed to aim forward towards your target, not just forward. If the camera has you like looking from the side, like I am right now, it'll make you do like a horizontal slice instead. Okay, more, keep it up. And that's parry attack. This is basically the Breath of the Wild counter, but much more simplified. Literally just as soon as you see the A button flash, just press it and you win. It's the OI win button. Incidentally though, sometimes because of the land geometry, you might end up missing the counter because Link is gonna like fall off the ledge while going around the opponent. Once more. That was a fine display. And yet, I sense a certain anxiousness in the sword you hold. A eagerness that goes far beyond the mere desire to be wielded on the fields of battle. I do not know what has happened, but I have faith in you. Somehow I doubt you will misuse that sword. You have it, Link. I give it freely. You may have it, Link. I give it freely. Take the blade with you. Would you give your 10-year-old a sword that it can actually cut and kill? Like, literally, go upstairs in your kitchen or whatever, or something like that. Look, take a look at your biggest kitchen knife and wonder to yourself, will I give this giant chicken knife to my 10-year-old and let them use it however they want? Think about that. Think about what this old man is doing right here. Because I can't cut those pigs right outside as much as I want. They won't die. In fact, they'll probably kill me in revenge. But it's something to consider. This town has no police force, and the guy that can't fight back just stays in his basement for forever and ever, so kinda lame. Anyway, to go to those woods up there, we actually have to go through back onto this island over here. Hell no. Not even gonna talk to you. So yes, we can see the pirate ship over there. It never gets closer. And it's supposed to be far enough that you can't swim to it unless you use the glitch I was talking about earlier. You can't see the people on it though, and you're supposed to interpret them as like, talking to each other, wondering what the hell were you guys thinking? Blowing the bird up while it was still in the air like that. Unfortunately, we can't climb faster than normal, I think, by jamming the B button like we could in Majora's Mask. That's kind of lame. Hey, Errol, I've got a sword. Oh, she doesn't care. I hope the person's okay. This is terrible. But I'm not actually going to do anything. I'm just going to stay here forever. I feel Errol should be trying something herself. Of course, that means she'd get in danger too, but, you know, she seems the adventurous type. Oh, and we can cut grass now that we have a sword too. Forest paths are closed until suspension bridge repairs are complete. Thank goodness there was only enough wood to keep ourselves from going there, because all we need is a sword and we can get past all the way up here. There's actually really no reason for anyone to go up here when I think about it. And wow, those woods look so flat. I know it was a GameCube game, but they should have made things a bit different for the HD version, I feel. Because this is N64 quality woods from a distance they've got right there. Just gonna check in this area out. I mean, in some sense, there's a lot of stuff in this game that feels like a precursor to what they would do in Breath of the Wild. And if you look carefully, you can in fact see islands off to the other ends. It's really cool. But for the most part, we're the only ones in this island. Like, this feels like this island, which is outside island, is completely, like, completely removed from the world. Like, this is the only remnants of civilization that exist here, which is roughly like 3 families and no more. Just want more money. You can carry tons of money in this game. Just FYI. Talk about lucky. If she had fallen directly onto the ground, she would be dead. But because she just got stuck on a branch like that, she's just barely alive. Terminal velocity? Never heard of it. I was kind of hoping to do some stuff with that guy, but nope. Yeah, the counter is not something that every enemy has. It's actually exclusive to a couple of enemies. But yeah, you don't need to do the counter against that thing, so it's whatever. I really should have done a lot more stealth. Like, it's not like you could do much, but it'd be kind of neat. This has a very MGS3 vibe to it, but it came out before MGS3, which is Metal Gear Solid 3. Yep, total lies. We know that Link has never gone to this fairy fountain here. Ocarina of Time, Link, specifically. And what the hell? Yeah, we could see past the wall right here. Let's see. I thought we could actually see, like, the ocean in this place, because technically we're still part of the island and within an ocean and something like that. So it'd be kind of neat if you could see the ocean from here, but it's just a it's not that. So it's like whatever. Oh no, reinforcements? You cannot really harm enemies that are on the floor. See? You've got lots of instability. Wow, what's with that getup? Well, whatever. So where am I? Oh, that's right. The giant bird came in.
Oi!
Miss! Miss Tetra! Oh, thank goodness, you're safe! When I saw you get dropped onto the summit, I thought for sure you'd... Summit? So the bird dropped me on top of some mountain? Well, wasn't that nice of it. Well, don't just stand there. Let's go. Time to repay our debt to that bird in full. Miss, what about this boy? Don't worry about him. Come on. Crap. We missed out on the other reward of the enemy. It was an orb that you break. Oh, well. Oi, big brother. Yeah, told you IRL was adventurous. And seagulls always follow her for whatever reason. Uh-oh. Runner! Very much a Japanese name for characters to say brother while they're in distress like that. Because it's Oni-san or something like that in Japanese. More emotional. Brother feels a little too clunky in English. It made more sense to just say their name. So, her saying Link would have made more sense. Anyway, stupid kid. See, this is what we mean by this Link having emotion. He actually does things that the player has no control over. He doesn't cry, though, when he really should have here. In my opinion. What? You want to come with us on our ship? You understand what you're asking? We're pirates. You know, pirates. The terror of the seas. What do we get out of bringing some helpless little kid along with us? I'll tell you what we get. A headache. I know how you must feel with your sister having been kidnapped and all. But that doesn't really have anything to do with us, now does it? And how do you figure that? Whoa there. Just who are you? Where do you get off butting in on someone else's conversation? Please. All I mean to say is that if you big bad pirates hadn't come to this quiet little island, that poor girl wouldn't have been snatched away by that bird. And just what do you mean by that? Just be quiet for a moment, and I'll tell you. Now, as my work entails delivering letters, I spend much of my time traveling amongst the many different islands. As a result, I hear many things. Haven't any of you heard word that young girls have been getting kidnapped lately from all regions of the Great Sea? No matter. Whether you've heard it or not, that seems to be the case. Young girls with long ears like yours have been getting kidnapped, never to be seen again. And unless my eyes fail me, the young girl who was just kidnapped from this island also has long ears, does she not? Much like you do, Miss Fearsome Pirate. My point is that this bird mistook that poor girl for you, and that's why it grabbed her. And correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe it was young Link here who saved you from the monsters in the forest, wasn't it? Is this true? I'm pretty sure everyone has long ears, by the way. Feels weird for the bird guy to mention that as the reason why the bird kidnaps all the girls with long ears. They all have long ears! Anyway, and while I'm at it, I may as well tell you that the bird that kidnapped both you and Link's sister has made its foul nest to the north, on the heights of the Forsaken Fortress. The Forsaken Fortress? Isn't that the place where... So what are you gonna do? Under the circumstances, I don't think it would be unreasonable for you to give Link a little help now, would it? I don't need you to tell me that. Even if I were to consider it, lately I've been hearing nothing but evil rumors about this forsaken fortress. You can't possibly mean to go there with nothing but a cheap little sword. That's not brave, it's stupid! I mean, come on! Even a simple island like this has to have something that you could use as a shield. You know, something to protect yourself with? Anything? Tell you what, if you come back with something like that, we'll let you stow away on our ship. Oh, and one more thing. Once we leave, you won't be coming back here for a while, so you'd better say goodbye, go say goodbye to your family while you have the chance. Really, right here, this is a mistake, and she should have said, we're never coming back here ourselves, so you better say goodbye to your family. I don't want you getting all weepy-eyed and so sick on me. Really, should have said, we won't be coming back here at all, because, it's like, why would they come back? The only reason they came here is because, the fact that she was captured and brought all the way here for whatever reason. It makes no sense, actually, when you think about it, that the bird was coming here. Because the bird's supposed to be going north. And we are at the bottom left-south of the map here. It implies, basically, that the bird captured Tetra, the pirate girl right here, back further south from here. Which makes no sense, but you know. How do you know my name? Well, I guess he is the postman. He probably read the letter. Good morning! Welcome to Allan Postal Service. What do you have for delivery? Nothing. Also, there was Miiverse functionality applied to this game. It's too bad Miiverse is offline forever now. Not even sure if I'm going to be able to do anything with Miiverse anymore. Oh well, guess we'll have to wait for the re-release of the HD version on the Switch. Or Switch 2 or whatever. Let's go ahead and buy the other bait that we could buy. Also, they do have boats, but we can't do anything with them. By the all-purpose bait.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
I wonder if some people try to get the silver membership before leaving the island. That'd be kind of neat. Perhaps even the gold membership. Because I don't think Beetle sticks around after you leave the island. He goes into the ocean, you have to find him yourself. A little difficult. Rip. She doesn't know. The shield is gone. Link. Is this what you're looking for? Take it with you. The legendary shield that has been used by the hero himself. It doesn't look like that. It has a lot of polys on it, though. See, the shield has depth, but not the doors. Why would the doors have depth? I guess it is true. Errol really has been kidnapped, hasn't she? What kind of monster could take such a sweet young child? My grandma's gonna be depressed for half the game now. We'll be able to cheer up eventually, though. Because thankfully, this Link is actually competent at rescuing people. Doesn't wait until the end of the game to do it. It's too bad Nintendo insists on having all the girls keep getting kidnapped over and over. Anyway, I got my shield, girl. Wow, that's a decrepit old shield. Are you sure you can still use that thing? Are you gonna get splinters and cry? Oh, whatever. If you're ready, then let's go. Are you ready? Yep. I'm gonna keep playing until I reach the Forsaken Fortress and get that event done with. Good luck, Link. Good luck finding Errol. Take care of yourself. This is literally all the villagers since Grandma and Errol right there. Grandma. Lost her two grandkids in one day. Anyway, how much longer is this going to go on, do you think? Do you have an estimate? Are you sure you shouldn't just quit right now? Seriously, think about it. I can tell you're just going to get more sentimental from here on out. There's still time, you know. Are you sure we shouldn't just turn around and take you back to the island? Petra is being a bit insensitive right now, but, well, people like it about her. That she's so insensitive. Link? Listen, kid, you can't just stand around on deck. You'll get in everyone's way. I've told Nico to look after you, so you better report below deck since asking what you should be doing. She's the captain, in case anyone's wondering. She's like one of the smallest members here, but she's in fact captain. Into the big blue, boys. Turn the ship full to starboard. We head for the northern seas. Listen, Shrimp, you're really creeping me out standing there like that, so quit it, yeah? Stay out of my way! Way out of my way! Mm-hmm. Hmm, that Nico didn't make out half bad, with you being the new swabby and all. You swabbies always get stuck doing the hardest work. It's a real raw deal, but hey, I'll tell you. It sure sounds like Nico is happy to finally not be the bottom rung of on the power ladder. You bet he is. Hey, but don't sweat it. I'm sure you'll do just fine, just as long as you don't disappoint. Oh, also... Huh. Okay, I was sure that the time was still moving while we were on the ship, but that doesn't seem to be the case. It just... turn from day to the afternoon real quick. You! Get out of the way, will ya? Turn around right now, climb down! Yep. Not much of a talker. So your name's Link, right? That's when we were get up you got on there. So what's the deal? Is that Poplar back on your island or what? I think about it though. I think I've seen enough like that before somewhere. Sure has. Stop right there! This is Miss Tetra's cabin! Most of us real pirates aren't even allowed in here. There's no way we're letting an outsider in. Don't you even think of it. Don't you even think of it. And we will get in that cabin up at some point. No worries. Because we all do want to go in there. Oh, well now. Ahoy there, swabby. As of today, I'm your superior, Nico. Now, I promise I'll go easy on you, so you do as I say, okay? Right. Now, first off, you have to take the test of all new pirates have to take. It's a bit of a doozy, so get ready. You watch everything I'm about to show you real careful-like, so you can cram it into your no-doubt mushy, swabby brain. More tutorial. First off, you gotta press the switch. This is the only easy part. Just walk up to it and Jump on it. Presto, switch pressed. Yep, you gotta jump on him. Okay, so I was able to jump to this one first one myself, but the next one is too far, right? Well, that's when you gotta do this. If you jump right at the rope, you can grab onto it and use the left stick to swing. Swing until you get close enough to the next platform. Then press A to let go and jump on it. Makes sense. So you think you get how to do it? You have to swing from platform to platform and try to get to the entrance of that room over there. Here's the problem though, Swabby. The platforms only stay raised for a little while, so if you don't get there by the time they drop, you have to start over. It'll probably take you at least 1 year before you're good enough to make it all the way here. One rough year, one tough year full of bumps and bruises. Of course, if you manage to do it faster, I'll reward you. Now give it a try, this ought to be good for a chuckle or two. Yeah, the designers think this will take you, like, one try, but for some people it might take a year, who knows, or they might purposely screw up until it takes them over a year. The reason why I pressed that thing is because I wanted to reset the platforms. You don't have to do it the way I'm doing it. You can actually sequence break past some of them. But like right here where I was, I actually could have just swung to this place right here. Yes, I did it already. As my underling. I wonder if it's okay to just give that to him. I don't see why not. I doubt I'll get busted. I'll get busted, that's what he said. Alright, Swabby, I'll tell you what. You can have the treasure in that chest over there. Your reward for the great and generous Nico. Hurry up and take it before someone else notices and comes. The chest designs are really cool in this game. There's like three tiers. The third tier is always makes you want to really open it, you know, because its design is so appealing. Very, very appealing. Hi. Hey Link, we've reached the Forsaken Fortress. Hurry up and get up here. That was really fast, all things considered. It's so lame. Well, I won't be around after I'm finished with what I do here. You know, the item he gave us is basically kind of worthless. It's just a bag to carry some other items. Kind of like the bait bag. Yep.
Come on!
Hey, Link! Here I am, up here! Gotta go all the way up there, but I first don't want to talk to this guy. The young miss is waiting for you up above. We've reached the Forsaken Fortress. What are you doing, chimp? Is waiting for you up in the crow's nest. Shake a leg. Yeah, go. Hoof it. I'll talk to this guy too. Was Nico's test easy? Really? Yes, it was very easy. The Forsaken Fortress. Why is there a ship on top of it? No idea. What were you doing with Nico? Don't tell me you were playing some stupid game for treasure. Were you? Well, whatever. There's something you need to see. Have a look over there. It's the cursed isle known as the Forsaken Fortress. There are all sorts of strange rumors about this place. What I do know is that long ago it used to be the head of no good group of pirates we used to compete with. But they were just small time. Now the place looks like it's actually pretty dangerous. Also the big bird right there. Haha, I knew it! Look! Over there! By that window! Have you ever seen so many seagulls locked like that before? I bet you anything that's the place where they got your sister locked up. Yeah, if you look at the beginning of the game, the seagulls always seem to flock to Errol. So, this is your indication that Errol's right over there. Looks like the whole place is under really tight guard. This won't work. We'd be spotted before we got anywhere near landing there. What do we do now? Sounds like she's got an idea. Barrel time! Also, apparently Link is tied up in the barrel, which means doesn't make much sense because we're gonna need to move a lot when we get there. Look, don't struggle. If you really want to get into that dangerous place like that, this is the only way to do it. Trust me. We pirates do this all the time! Don't worry about it. It'll be a piece of cake. Is everybody ready? Never you fear, kid. We're pros. We're going to launch you good. 3, 2, 1! They actually miss. And we dropped our sword somehow. We dropped it higher up than where we actually landed. Don't question the logic. Anyway, stealth mission is go. This is actually a really annoying stealth mission, especially when you're younger. Because screwing up means actually restarting quite a bit of content. Anyway, your sword had landed all the way up there. Shoot! I'm sorry. I apologize. I guess my aim was off by a little bit. The look on your face. Priceless! She gave us a shining stone before we departed. I slipped a stone into your pocket just before we fired you over there. It's no ordinary stone either. I can see what you're doing through this stone, and obviously you can hear me through it, so if you see A, you better press that button. I put a stone on your quest status screen. Use right on the item screen to take a look at it. It's pretty basic. I can't do it right now, unfortunately. Hey, but listen carefully. I need this back after you save your sister, so don't go losing it. You understand? Alright then, down to brass tacks. The courtyard is awash with searchlights, so they'll see you right away if you just go charging in. Better think it through. Yep, I can see the shining stone and my shield in the Wii U controller. You can also see the map. It only shows the Forsaken Fortress right now. The map I'm really interested in is actually the map for the ocean. I don't think, unfortunately, I'll be able to show it to y'all because I'm in Wii U mode right now. I might switch to Wii U Pro Controller mode because of that. So yeah, this is how you stealth through the place. Easy enough to understand, right? We want some money, so let's get some money. Okay, I think that's enough money. Also, there's a ladder right over there, but we can't reach it. So we gotta use the stairs. That was actually really close. I actually didn't think the light would have reached all the way up there. There are guards too, so don't fool around. Like, it's one thing to get caught by the searchlights. It's quite another to get caught by the guards. No, it's specifically because we don't have a sword that we are screwed to actually have to always surrender if we get caught by a guard. Got the compass! You guys unfortunately won't be able to see it, because when I pause, this is what happens. I wonder if I should go to the other side. Is this the jail? I don't think so. Guess I'll check the other side. I'm dedicated now. Wow, is this really the other side? Okay, I guess it is. Listen up, Link. There's a monster running the searchlight up there. You can slay the monster and just maybe I'll shut the searchlight down. Oh, but you're unarmed, aren't you? All you have is a shield. If I were you, I'd try to use my shield to deflect the monster's blows and see if I could make it drop its weapon. If you did, you could pick up its weapon and... Hey! That's just me. What will you do? Can use... other weapons. Yeah, these Deku sticks or whatever are shockingly effective as weapons. And also, this is a thing you can do in this game. You can actually pick up weapons other than your sword to use as, well, you know, weapons. And there's quite a few. They deal a lot of damage, but unfortunately, they're generally not that great. But yeah, that's one searchlight down, so hooray for us. And the other searchlight is over there, which we can get to by just jumping from here. So you can see the parts are still over there. The enemies will in fact try to pick up another weapon if they lose their weapon. Not that dumb. Except they are, but you know. That's both searchlights taken care of. But there's another searchlight over there. Why are we taking care of searchlights? I think it's because they're positioned in such a way that you can't progress while they're active. So yeah, there's actually three searchlights. And there was an invisible wall right there that prevented me from going further. God damn it. I have to go through here. At least that door has a handle that's clearly visible. Ah, and this is the jail. This is where you'll get stuck if you get found. You basically just have to leave the place by crawling through a hole. It's not that big of a deal. And here we have the map. But where do we wish to go? You guys can't see it, but, huh. Okay, this must be the actual jail where you get stuck. Never mind. Can't open the door, even though we clearly should be able to. You'd immediately leave the place and then get the map. Cool design. Here we have the last place. Take care of the torchlights. What's wrong? Come a little closer! Aww. I think it's possible to make them fall. Damn it. He's got the high ground. And yes, you do drop your weapon if you get hit. Thankfully, you picked them up pretty quickly, at least. So now that all searchlights have been taken care of, well, nothing. I think we can go through that door at the center, maybe? It's been a long time since I played Wind Waker, so I'm not actually positive how you're supposed to proceed with the game. There's also a small opening down there. Okay, I guess we can go through here. You can still get caught by, not rats, but guards. Like these. Guards like that one over there. There's a treasure chest over here. Oh, and yeah, this is what the map looks like. Well, this is obviously a more simplified version of it, but it's relatively close to what this is supposed to represent. Neat. Not these enemies. Didn't expect so many guards here. Their range of view is basically their lights. That's how far they can see. It will instantly detect you if you are moving while you're in their light. I think they also detect you if they touch you while you're in the barrel. Maybe not. This is gonna take a while. I apologize. But there is, in fact, a treasure chest on the other side here, so we really want that. We could get it later in the game, but let's get it now. God, look at that guy's ass. And look at how dumb he is. God damn it, I can't open that door! Ah, there it is. Gotta press a switch to open this door that has a handle. Terrific design. Give me the piece of heart. Yep. It also refills my health. Very good. And now I gotta go the way back, which is not ideal, but it's something we have to do. Be mindful that some barrels do not function the way you might expect. Some of them you really do just end up carrying on top of your head. I could let myself get caught to show what happens when you get caught, but you know, I've been doing my stealth segment pretty perfectly up until now, so let's keep that pace up, you know? But yeah, they're pretty blind. They really only see up from the range of their lanterns. No more. If you attack them, they will instantly detect you though. Just saying that right now. These enemies detect you, but they don't capture you. Don't know why, because they can damage you. Of course, there's no way you can hide from them, so it would be kind of unfair. Okay, I believe, yeah, if you swam through the small hole, you'd be able to go here instantly. Therefore, oh no, it looks like that ladder. Does that ladder reach the water? Well, if it does, then that means you can go here instantly to bypass a whole bunch of the fortress. Kinda neat. Probably could have sneaked by that guy, but nope. And have any of you been stuck like in a container or something like that? Being inside that barrel right now must be extremely uncomfortable for the player character. There needs to be some air holes, you know? Anyway, speaking of uncomfortable, that guy's going in a circle. I was kind of hoping he would just walk by me. But as I said, this is kind of boring. And now he's going counterclockwise. Okay. Let's just keep staring at his ass. Treasure. Treasure, and we almost got hit by an eye laser statue up there. Jeez. 10 rupees. Not too shabby. Because these are the dormitories.
Yep.
So do we go left or right? Oh, we have to go here. There's a red mark on the map, basically telling me where I'm supposed to go. And this crate, which I must use. Yep. Aha! I've got it, Link! In order to reach the tall tower where your sister's being held, you have to find a room right below the tower. You gotta take the door to the outside and then climb up from here. Got that? Not really. Like, thanks to the Wii U gamepad map, it's a lot clearer what I have to do, but even so, the way she described it in dialogue right there still doesn't really make much sense in terms of like figuring out where you're supposed to go. It's much easier to just follow the map with the big red mark that shows where you need to go. Because you're not familiar with the layout of the map is the problem. You need to first be familiar with the layout of the map before you're able to give the player directions on how to go through it. Ah, now we're in the room above. Okay, yeah, I see. Goddamn rats. The glow effects from their lanterns were not as smooth in the GameCube original, by the way. If I remember correctly, it was actually just a yellow circle they used for displaying how far they can see in the GameCube original. Not this smooth gradient they've got going on right now. See how quickly we can get caught? All I did was move a little bit and he was already like, huh? Just a box. Also, that rat can push me down into the pit below. Stupid rat. Just a barrel. Ignore it. Oh god. I think he's stuck on a loop. Oof, that was close. Almost got caught, but almost getting caught is not the same as getting caught, thankfully. Yes, game. You had to show me that, even though it's a linear road all the way up to my sword right here. Although there is one more guard that we have to pass through. And if you get caught by this guard right here, it's all the way back to the jail cell that I showed to you guys earlier. Very annoying. I remember getting caught like 3 times trying to get through this segment. And it's like an hour of gameplay time because I kept getting caught. Because you get a little impatient when you get this far, you know? And you might accidentally hit the control stick when you don't mean to, and because of that you get caught when you didn't want to get caught. Also, you want to hit these guys with the barrel, thinking that'll hurt them. Instead, it just means you get caught. Lame. You cannot jump into this thing, even though it kind of looks like you can. And if you can jump to it, then there's nothing you can do inside of it. Don't even bother. But yeah, there'd be searchlights all over the place here if you hadn't taken care of them. And especially right here, you'd get caught, almost guaranteed. I believe there's a searchlight that goes through here. Probably from that, those searchlights over there, I guess. What happens if you jump down there anyway? Oh, you can. I should drop down there to open up the passages. I believe this will help for later, which is why I'm doing it right now. What? What? I had no idea I can blow those crates up! What the hell is this game? What the hell is this, Wind Waker? Okay, I need to drown myself real quick to see if it's gonna respawn me at the door up there. Cause that saves me quite a bit of time. Although it's super lame that I actually lost a bit of progress like that right there. Like, holy crap. I did not expect a crate to just blow up. Anyway, BRB drowning. And otherwise we'll go through there to continue. It's not a game over if you drown, unlike Ocarina of Time. It's just, you get damaged a bit. Unless, of course, they changed it. Nope, they did not, and thankfully it worked exactly the way I wanted it to. I'm back up here. Okay. Crisis averted, but we do have to restart sneaking past that guy right there. And screw making up. Screw opening up a passage again. We're just gonna go straight up this time. I thought it'd be nice to just open up a passage to getting back up to the top of the tower later in the game, because we will have to go through this place again later in the game, but it won't be a stealth segment by then, so I'll just destroy all the enemies going up instead. God damn it. Thankfully, I don't need a crate to climb up back here. One more time, and you don't want to fall here at all. Epic boss music for this fight, but this is a generic enemy. You got back the hero sword you dropped. Now you're in business. Take care not to drop it again. I think now that you have a sword, you don't get captured anymore. But I could be wrong. And yes, I stole the guy's sword. Try to attack me now, buddy. Oh, you can't. You can kick me. Yep. Very logical. Yeah, but yeah, the game doesn't let you go back now that you've got the sword, so. Cutscene time. And then I'll be taking a break, because I've been playing for well over an hour and a half. Although this cutscene is going to be pretty long, now I think about it. Good 10 minutes, I want to say. Yes, Link, just walk right into the light. The thing that you were supposed to do, avoid doing the entire time, but no, now you screw up. You got too excited to save your sister. Anyway, we can't fight this boss yet. We don't have the required item. Even Link gets captured here. Those two other girls, by the way, are relatively important side quest NPCs for later. Now who's this handsome man? Yeet! That bird knows how to throw far. In the CRT TV, which is a lot less resolution and view, it was a lot harder to tell who that was. But in the HD version, especially with a large TV, it is very, very easy to tell who that is.
Hey.
Link. Link. Wake up, Link. How do you know my name, whoever you are? Pull yourself together, Link. Well, have you come to your senses yet? You are surprisingly dull-witted. Did I startle you? I suppose it is only natural. As wide as the world is, I am the only boat upon it who can speak the words of men. I am the King of Red Lions. Do not fear, I am not your enemy. Link, I have been watching you since you went to the Forsaken Fortress to rescue your sister. I understand how your desire to protect your sister could give you the courage to fearlessly stand up to anything. But such a bold attempt was foolhardy. I suppose you saw him, a shadow that commands a monstrous bird. His name is Ganon. He who obtained the power of the gods, attempted to cover the land in darkness, and was ultimately sealed away by the very power he hoped to command. He is the very same Ganon, the emperor of the Dark Realm the ancient legends speak of. I do not know why the Seal of the Gods has failed, but now that Ganon has returned, the world is once again being threatened by his evil magic. Tell me, Link, you still wish to save your sister from him? And will you do anything to save her? I see. In that case, I shall guide you as we go forward, advising you on what you should do and where you must go. Ganon cannot be defeated by human hands, let alone by what little strength you possess. The key to defeating Ganon is locked away in a great power that you can wield only after much toil and hardship. Do you understand? In that case, we depart to the Great Sea. Ah, but I am getting ahead of myself. It is actually a bit embarrassing for me to admit, but although I am indeed a boat that possesses the power of speech, I possess no sail, and a boat with no sail can sail no seas. I have brought you far to the east of the dark gaze of the Forsaken Fortress. On this island is a town of merchants who deal in a wide variety of goods. If you search hard enough, surely you can find one who will sell you a sail. I'm sorry to ask this of you, but without a sail, I will be useless to you. He actually can move without a sail, it's really slow. And it would be kind of a miserable experience to sail the seas that slowly. Anyway, this island of merchants is home to many valuable goods. The information that they provide you may come in handy during your endeavors at sea, so listen carefully to their words and heed them well. But remember, there is no time to play. Come back here immediately as soon as your errands are done. You can take all the time you want. There just isn't much to do right now. But that will be for another time. Right now, I gotta take a break. We're gonna take a save real quick. Oh, also, now I can finally see the map of the Great Ocean. The island we start on is not actually completely at the bottom half. Not bottom half. The bottom left of the sea. It's actually one off of that. One off of the corner. But whatever the case, saving. Wow, it takes quite a while to save. There we go. Game has been saved. Hope you've all enjoyed this video and I'll have you next day. Next time, we explore Windfall Island, which is where we were. It's actually quite interesting and neat.